Hi, welcome back in the new episode. To reduce the cost of PCB creation, I've designed MSPC version 2 with two extension cards at once, PGA and FPGA. Today's episode is about the FPGA extension card. Some time ago, I decided to use Lattice ECP5 FPGA with 84K logic elements. Looking at today's prices, I've decided to use it from my electronics storage shelf. That FPGA is quite complex, so I'm not sure if my board will work starting from the first revision. For the configuration part, I use RP2040. I have a lot of them inside my storage. There are some GitHub repositories with JTAG interface implementation on RP2040, so I have some starting points. RP2040 will also handle bus management towards the MSPC motherboard. I can attach up to two devices on a single connector, and this was created especially for that purpose, to use both configurator and the FPGA itself, so my motherboard can communicate with JTAG interface or with FPGA. Let's walk through essential points in the schematic. The configuration of FPGA was designed mainly according to the ECP5 datasheet and its design reference manuals. However, I also used some existing open source PCBs with the ECP5 FPGA family. The configuration will be stored in an external QSPI flash, and the configuration pins will be driven from RP2040. I have some ideas for implementing other architecture CPUs on that card that will interwork with the MSPC board. So I also added HyperRAM memory on that board to be used for them. The selected HyperRAM chip is powered by 1.8V, so I've reserved one GPIO bank. I will select the actual chip during parts ordering, but I think I will go for this one. The power section for the FPGA expansion card must be added to provide 1.1V for FPGA cord, 2.5 for FPGA aux, and 1.8 for HyperRAM. I saw that those DC-DC are used for ECP5 FPGAs and are also pretty cheap, so I use them. JTAG Programmer is built using RP2040. I followed the RP2040 hardware design document. RP2040 is a little bit easier than RP2350 since it contains internal LDO instead of DC-DC regulator and thus requires fewer external components. But it is almost the same as designing RP2050 in previous episodes. I wired an external USB connector together with a power supply. Thanks to that, I should be able to use my extension card standalone before integration with the MSPC board. To secure the USB host, I added fuse and ESD protection diodes. So I required a power supply selector. I used MOSFET with a Schottky diode to create a simple switching circuit. Let's see it inside the simulation. I also wired some LEDs to the FPGA and RP20 JTAG interfaces on this board through Debug and showed the device state. I've added a crystal connected to a clock input pin for the FPGA clock. Then I created a PCB that must fit in 50x50mm in size. It's quite a small board, so again, it was a challenge to fit everything in such a small space. I use a 6-layer stack-up since it was cheap with 3 vias in pad in the manufacturer that I plan to use. This board is also split into sections with the FPGA card and its memories, JTAG programmer, power supplies, and the connector. It was a challenge to wire all connections and place all those decoupling capacitors. I placed them under FPGA to make the wire between the pad and the capacitor as short as possible. I had to move RP2040 with its memory and SD card and some small parts at the bottom side to fit them all. This board will be the hardest to solder in my full experience due to the FPGA and HyperRAM VGA footprint. But if I succeed, I will be really proud of myself. We will see in the future. If I fail, I will order PCB with assembly next time. That's all for today. Let me know what you think and see you soon. Bye!